be looking at Slapdash from the Storm side. If your demo did not start up, reconnect to the stream. If you can't hear me correctly, my suggestion is that when you load up the stream and it says what audio volume do you wish to choose, it should be two notches away from the farthest left. That should be the volume that you should be using for the, this is like the audio master volume on that selection. If you do not have that currently set like that, please leave and rejoin and correct your volume. Just hop back on. I need to do a little bit of changing, but I'm going to let you guys listen to some music for a few more seconds, and then we should be getting this thing going. We're still waiting on the EXE and a few more pen players to join up on the server, so it might be a little while, guys. We'll get into a little bit of map discussion before it starts. Forgot I had one shout-out to do. This is coming from Alpha Sentinel, but he wants to give a shout-out to Dow, who apparently the entire team has retired. A couple of guys I know, I met them at Fogeyland that the Geezers held here down in Texas, and a lot of them have joined up with Pendragon, so shout-out to you guys from Alpha Sentinel. Wish you the best of luck.
Our scouts report heavy dirt activity in this region. Stay alert.
I've been here before.
No.
I can't take this any longer. I won't heal until I'm stronger. Strong enough to not be afraid. Oh, would anybody think? Oh, would anybody say?
Okay, guys, Nordrimor coming back at you here. One second.
Hello.
It's kind of a little bit awkward. There'll be some delays in the transitions when I turn down the music and stuff like that. T2TV isn't quite as fluid as regular shoutcasting in that respect. But anyway, we're on Slapdash. Looks like they've opted to play that map first here on the Pendragon server where we're at. Still missing a few EXE guys. Penn's got 15 on the server, and EXE only 11 right now. But over here on the Storm side, which is the side that EXE will have, Penn's over there on Inferno. Talk about Slapdash here for a little bit. Very, very old map. First came out, of course, with T2. Updated for the X-Pack, they made the flight ceiling a little bit higher, so it wasn't quite as low. There's actually a few mountains, I think, on Slapdash that were taller than the flight ceiling that you couldn't go over in Shrikes or Bombers. But anyway, Slapdash, one of the most enjoyable vehicle maps, in my opinion, and one of the best maps in Tribes 2. I've always had a lot of fun on this map. I don't know why, but I have just always really enjoyed it. And that's just the way things have been since, since it started. So, Slapdash, I had to say, personally, I do prefer the storm side on Slapdash, just mainly because of the location of the terrain around the flagstone. I like having that nice big hill and the narrow path there in front of the flagstone. I think that helps block off some capper escape routes. Other than that, the map's fairly similar. The AA turret and sensor, I think, are also in slightly better position. Well, it defaults to missiles, not AA, but often changed out to AA. Slightly better positions to assist on the flag right there. That sensor way over there, though, completely useless and goes down fast and really doesn't provide that much bonus. If in case you didn't know, the deployable pulse sensors in Classic actually have the same detection radius as one of these medium base pulse sensors. These things right here, those are called medium base pulse sensors. There's a large and a small model. This is the, or I should say a large and a medium. This is the medium model, and due to some changes in Classic, the deployable pulse sensors now do match the medium base pulse sensors in range. The large ones, though, still have considerable more range than either the deployable or the mediums. But back over here towards the Slapdash base, everybody knows there's two sentry turrets, one on the invents, one near the gens, and two generators. And over here on the V-pad, it is wide open, and there are plenty of positions all around this V-pad for spam, and bombers, also another favorite, and just some general shrike flybys, also very powerful. So one of the tactics you will always see used on Slapdash, mainly because Slapdash really isn't the most ski-friendly map, especially now in the Classic with a terrain that's still somewhat flat, has a little bit prone to the skiing bug, but Slapdash has always been a bit of a vehicle map, and while cappers can often get back home on foot, they don't need a vehicle, escort to get away necessarily. Vehicles for the offense and even shrikes for defense and the MPV for defense are very, very important. But the main problem is that there's a considerable distance between that V-pad and that flag area. Also, all the spawn points are right back there, none near the flag area. And I think that's what keeps Slapdash so interesting and intriguing, is the fact that it's a very split nature defensively. You got to really come out from the base in order to defend the flag, so you got to spread your resources a little thin. Either got to defend the base, or you got to defend the flag, and, you also got to guard the V-pad a little bit. The gens or the V-pad go down, you're going to be hurting, and you've also got to keep the flag covered, keep the MPV up around the flag. It can be really hard to get that MPV back out there if the MPV goes down, and this map has a ton of strategies. I've seen tanks used on this effectively. I've seen Havocs, from what Core pulled off last week. They just brought a Havoc full of lights over here, a lot of them with shield packs, and they just dueled the flag area and controlled it via that. They just out-dueled all the light defense and kept that under control like that, since, the nature of a split spawn means that the defense has to come out to the flag area. They had a couple lights just camping there waiting for guys to come out after they killed them, and then just, dueled them down for a couple minutes and kept the flag area from getting any defenses or MPVs or inventories or turrets set up. So a lot of things can work on this map. Bombers, of course, always very popular, both for clearing the flag stand and for taking out the V-pad. And, a lot of guys like to eject and usually medium shield and go for the gens here, but I've seen spam on the gens. Believe it or not, yes, you can spam the gens down on this map, just like the V-pad. It's a difficult angle, but if you get it right here against this wall, notice you can see out through that little doorway. That means that a mortar can fly through that doorway, hit this back wall, and damage that generator and potentially take it out. So there's always the opportunity, if you can get a hoe way the heck back there, to spam on the gens. I really don't think that's the most useful place for a heavy offense to be, since he has to go a considerable distance to get behind the enemy base just to spam it down, but whatever works. So that pretty much concludes most of the pre-match discussion for the map. Still missing some EXE players. Let's see if they got an Observer. Hopefully those are both EXE players and Observer. That'll bring them up to 13, and they're still one shy. But Slapdash, I think the flags are like 1,053 meters apart, something along those lines. And I think that's one of the most ideal distances for a map size in T2, both Classic, Base, and Base++. It's not big like Reversion, which I think is 1,500, and it's not tiny like some maps where it's like, you know, 300, 400, 500, 600 meters away. So there's a bit of a, still a bit of chasing possible. Although Classic, if you have a good cap route, you can really come off this flax end. I've seen several routes that just come off this flax end, hop over this like ridge line right here. This is for the storm side. Usually hit some of these hills or something along those lines, and it's a nice little bull route there, and this will whip you right back across this part of the map, and you'll hopefully clear this hill or come over here to the side where you can ski down to it and come right back down, and you're back to the flag stand. Cap times are actually still fairly low in Classic if you get off the flag stand without any problems, but if you don't, you're still going to be in a world of hurt because getting a good, nice, everyone, you know, getting, as in Classic, getting a lot of speed off the flag stand is very conductive to caps, and we'll see how much light offense pressure. That is one of the other tactics I have seen employed on Slapdash, is actually not light offense around the flag stand, but a considerable amount hanging on the, I don't know, I want to say the limbs and the hills and waiting in the weeds and just sitting back from a fair distance and doing a little O sniping and disc spamming, maybe some nade spam if they can get up high enough and get enough or get it close enough, and just sitting back here harassing the light defense, preventing them from stopping a capper, and all the capper then has to do is get the flag out a couple hundred meters, I don't know, I'd say usually right about here, a little bit away from the flag stand area, and then they just swarm it with escorts on foot, and they just try to pick up the flag and rally it, or relay it back all the way to their flag stand. Chain Gun leaving the game. EXT's up to 12 players. Pendragon has 13, so this should get started up soon, guys. That's all the pre-match discussion for Slapdash that I really had to talk about. Not a whole lot of surprises left on a map like Slapdash, unless you're going to be doing something crazy like Corded and bring out a Havoc full of lights. But there's still just plenty of strategic options to use on this match, and it's always fun for me to watch a map like this to see what our team's going to use and where are they going to attack. So with that, I'm going to crank the music back up and just let it slide for a few minutes because it looks like EXC and Penn still have a few things to work out. EXC up to 13, Penn's got their 14, waiting on one more player for EXC to get up to their full roster. And until that happens, a little bit of more music and, a little, and just some waiting. Shout out to the Pendragon players from Precept who can't play tonight because he's getting owned by his ISP.
It's Friday night and she's all alone. He's a million miles away. She's dressed to kill, but the TV's on. He's connected to the sound and she's got pictures on the wall of all the girls.
Let me make two more points clear for anyone who might be jumping in on the cast right now. If you are not seeing the demo stream, a.k.a. the video, then you need to reconnect to the stream. Sometimes there's a glitch where the demo doesn't start up correctly, so just reconnect to the stream real quick at the latest point, probably. And another thing is, if you can't really hear my voice that well, you need to go back and change the in-game master volume. Again, two notches from the leftmost slider. And that little audio slide right there, again, two notches away from the left, one, then two. And that's where you should probably have that slider in order so that. The main thing is that prevents the in-game sounds from masking and just being so loud that they cover up my voice during the actual match. Rhapsody by request. Shout out to Chain Gun for coming back from retirement from Luna Warrior, and shout out to G-Spot 2's mother from Tremor, who can confirm that he is not a 15-second man. Sorry guys, I gotta turn off the music here. We have a match starting. One sec, I gotta get my audio settings and everything cranked up to the correct levels. Okay, things look like they're pretty good on my end. 15 seconds until it starts. I'm gonna give a rundown of some of the rosters. One sec, we'll not be able to talk to you guys after this, so please don't PM me unless there's a serious problem. Rundown again on the rosters, voice-wise, as soon as the countdown finishes, it rewatch, it'll reorganize the rosters the second it starts.
Match begins.
Looks like they can play 13 versus 13 on Storm. It is the Unhandled Exceptions, Bruce Lee, Arnie, Grad, Codeman, Shaman, Killbox, Freaky, Shola, Humpstuff, Arsenic, Orion, Shane Gun, and Nebok. Over on Inferno, it is Pendragon, Varkus, Mason the Fist, Munkus, Arvid, Anchorage, Psychotic Just, Dragon Reborn, Shaggy, Kobe Tai, and then Irish 5-7, Kesh, and Biggs. Looks like we're over here on the Inferno side, so that's the Pendragon side. They're getting a bomber going right off the bat, a second bomber already going. Do they have the MPB out by the flag? No, indeed they don't, just a deployable inventory station, but a bomber in the air, second one on its way, Shrike's going out to escort it, and I'm going to follow this bomber over here in from the Pendragon side real quick. There we go, locked onto that bomber. It's got Anchorage and one other player into it. I'm going to stay locked into that for just one second as it flies across the skies. No incoming offense that I can see see as we cruise past the Infernal Flagstand, but there is a mortar flying out from maybe a tail gunner spot. Shrike's dueling it out as some bombers making some runs. MPB looks like it just exploded over here on the Storm Flagstand. Bomber clips the side of the building there a little bit, loses a lot of energy, but got to grab already, pick up Arvid as he comes in after the bomber. Clear, where are you? Arvid, come on. There we go. Arvid, pick up the flag. He's got a Shrike in him already. Took a lot of damage coming off the Flagstand. One Shriker directly behind him. He's down deep into the red, coming back over the last ridgeline, really. There's his Flagstand already within visual range. Looks like it's getting attacked by some heavy offense. He tosses the flag as he clears the hill line, getting sniper line of sight. Tries to pass off to a teammate. Picked up there by the Farmer. Farmer destroyed on the Flagstand. Loses it. Flag is taken away by Arsenic for the unhandled exceptions. He's got almost full health here coming off the Flagstand. Back over here to Irish 57. He fishes the flag out of the front hill. Has the enemy flag on his back. And in the meantime, Arsenic has totally slipped away with the Pendragon Flagstand. So both teams now away with the enemy flag and have it back to their base. Bomber being bottom, getting a little bit of a vehicle observer HUD ownage right there. But Arsenic has already come back to his side. He's still got most of his health. Hasn't really been touched since he got the flag. No chasing on him whatsoever. Shrike coming in for a rundown. Not finding a whole lot of love. But where are you, Irish 5-7? Irish 5-7's in a heavy with a shield pack. Looks like he's going to be retreating indoors with that flag, or maybe taking it off the flag stand. Not sure, but looks like Irish 5-7 going to take that flag out to the flag stand. And Hofgear is what it looks like. There's no MPB out there. He's picked up in a bad spot. Doesn't have much juice. It takes a Mindus. About to go down. He's down to a tiny sliver of red now. Irish 5-7, get back on him. Irish 5-7, they're taken out just a tiny bit. He loses the flag, picked up there by Dragon of Horn. I apologize for the switchover. Looks like I'm getting owned by the bomber, unfortunately. It's constantly switching over to lock me onto it when players jump out of it. But some grenades coming in on Dragon Reborn now. He takes a little bit of incidental damage, but not a whole lot on him. Retreating back now towards the flag. Let's pick up Arsenic on the other side. Arsenic's taking a... And I get locked back on the bomber. Arsenic over here in the backfield, spiking it off to teammate Shaman. Shaman here bouncing around. Once again, let's see. They're still playing 13 versus 13. Sage Desk for Pendragon. Looks like he was supposed to rejoin and actually make EXE play down a man. But otherwise, looks like they're just going to go straight up for 13 versus 13 for a while. But both teams' bases are looking pretty good. I haven't seen any vehicle pad outage, and I haven't seen any gen outage. Looks like a sentry turret got destroyed there, so it looks like they got hammered a little bit. But if the gens or V-pad were offline, they weren't offline for very long. EXE has them back up already. Maybe a little bit of Shrike Rassing. Look, there we go. Incoming bomber. Players ejecting it, ejecting from an ally. Looks like they're going for the flag carrier. On the other side over here, this is Dragon Reborn. He's hiding inside medium shield. Shola outside. I'm sorry, not Shola. Oh, yeah, it's been passed off to Shola. Shola here outside, taking a little bit of pain. Uses his parakeet. He's back under the green. Run down there. Shola taken out by Mason the Fist, I think it was. Just completely screamed and run over and by the Shrike, picked up there by Arnie. Arnie getting bounced around by a lot of dish, down to less than half of his life. Shrike, now I get locked over again. I'm getting owned totally by the vehicle bug on this map. But Arnie here getting bounced around by discs and chain gun fire. He's down to a tiny sliver, does not have anything, no pack, nothing. Now comes out, looks like his team is beaten back all the infiltrators, heads on inside to get suited up. Pick up Dragon Reborn on the other side. He's still inside. Heavy mortars exploding from the outside. Heavy there in the backfield, and once again getting owned by the bombers getting bought. Fortunately, guys, sorry about that. There's not much I can do to prevent that. It just happens on some maps and some servers. But Arnie here hanging around in the backfield, and Dragon Reborn still medium shielding it over by his base. Flag standoff, guys, took, I think, less than 2 minutes to get into here on Slapdash, and I get picking up on some more people as they buy vehicles. Arnie here still playing it outside, and on the other side, Dragon Reborn still opting it to keep it inside. And Ogre has left the game. He was saying, team me, please. I don't know which team he's for, but it looks like it would have to be from Storm. There's now a lot of people on server mode, so some players need to get team there. Minion joining the Pendragon team, so they actually have a two-man advantage right now. There's two people in observer mode that are probably saying, you know, team me and put me on the correct team. Jive, I don't know, let me hang on this thing. If I have admin, it can help these guys out. I don't think I do. There's not much, let's see. I do have admin. Let me team some of these guys real quick. See who these guys are. Grad Ogre. I don't know what team he's supposed to be on. Storm, I guess? Well, sorry, looks like they're getting him right now. Team Ogre. Brad says Ogre says team me to Storm. I'm going to do that for him. Well, never mind. They beat me to it. In order to more taking a break there, try to do some admin work, but they got to resolve without me, so that's good. Looks like we should be up to 14 versus 14. There we go. Finally, up to 14 versus 14. Dragon Reborn and Arnie here panning around. Arnie here just dancing out here in the midfield. He's got one escorter right next to him. It is, let's see if I can get it. It's Hump Stuff. And over here, well, look, it locked onto a vehicle as it explodes. This Dragon Reborn is just, just waiting there indoors. Arnie has a drop on the other side, taken out by a tank mortar shot from Shaggy One and returned by Shaggy One. Shaggy's killed by a missile turret. Second later, but got the return. I wasn't on him. Grabbed by Grad, though. He comes into the game. Snags it in a cloak pack, of all things. grabs the flag in a cloaker, has very little juice or speed. He is taken out not far from the flag stand, and the flag is dropped, and I am just getting totally owned by Observer locking me onto vehicles, but the flag will be returned. Charging the stand is Dragon Reborn. He's still in a medium shield, and I'll switch out of it. He's going straight for that flag stand. There's shrikes, there's heavies all over it. Dragon Reborn cutting a path through it. The flag stand gets the cap, right as mortars land behind him from some heavy offense, but cap 1-0 now in favor of Pendragons here on the first map, Slapdash, and the teams have been evened up. MPB under some serious pressure here. Mortars and mines looks like flying at it from enemy offense, but the MPB just absolutely smoking, and I get panned over to a mess load of players jumping out of bombers. I apologize, guys. I'm just getting whipped around by people buying vehicles by a glitch in the Observer HUD. Mason the Fist has a grab, and there we go. Vark is buying a Shrike. I get locked on him, and here we go. Mason the Fist here with the flag. He's off the flag stand into the air. Shriker trying to come on from behind and knock him. They got him knocked down. He takes a little bit of skiing gnome damage. The skiing gnomes just come out of the ground right there and totally owns Mason the Fist. He tries to pass it off, but can only throw it to himself. It's flying down the hill, and I get locked onto a bomber as it gets returned by Humpstuff. Grad here is jumping out of a Shrike, looks like, coming back. Shrike comes in for the rundown. No, it was too high. Grad here coming back with nearly full health, with a lot of speed, not a whole lot of energy right now, but cruising back home very comfortably. Shrike coming in from the rundown. Shrike blows up. Grad's still going. He's coming straight down to the Stanford. Hits it, gets the cap. 18-second route on Slapdash for Grad as an incoming bomber locks me onto the capper, ejecting from a bomber to try to pick up that flag, and on the other side, Anchorage has a grab as well. I'm sorry, that was Jive that just got missiled up the keister, and Anchorage here has a snag, takes a nade in the back that sends him flying, a little bit of chain gun fire follow-up finishes him off, and I get locked onto Varkus once again. Varkus is just absolutely owning me. I'd leave and rejoin the server, but I had to start a new stream on T2TV perhaps to do that. Don't worry about it too much, though. I apologize, guys, that it's being so mean. Right now, we got to grab Freaky here, coming in doing a back-to-front, just like Brad was here. Grabbing the score tied up now 1-1. Freaky here coming back with it, and a chain gun fire all behind him. He's down to a tiny sliver of red, doesn't have as much speed as Brad did coming off the flag stand, and incoming Striker ejects and goes for him, trying to beat Freaky to the flag stand. Freaky's flag taken there by Varkus, who jumps out of his shrike and forces me to lock onto him. Freaky here coming back, needs some help, loses the flag, dies in a gully there, and picked up by teammate Shola. Shola here with the flag, retreating back up the hill. He's got a fair bit of health there, and a lot of vehicles flying around. It looks like a bomber. Let's go pick up Varkus on the other side. Varkus here tosses the flag off, chunking it, trying to get to a teammate, but instead it slides down the hill and into the valley there next to the plant, where it hasn't been picked up at all. There we go. Minion's going to get a hand of it. Shola there charges the stand, but doesn't get it. Minion's going for a vehicle taken out on the side of the hill, loses the flag stand, returned by Arsenic, and Shola was waiting for the cap. 2-1, and the unhandled exceptions have turned this around, and it's now 21-21 remaining on the clock, so still plenty of time for either team to walk away with it. Cap out on Slapdash is 6, and it might get to that. Well, who knows? One sec. Though it's a little dry here this evening, but now watching the Storm Unhandled Exception flag stand, they've got their MPB parked out fairly closely. They're leaving it up as a missile turret right now. Up here, they're sticking with the missile turret on top of the base as well. Bomber pieces scattered around the base would probably indicate that maybe a raping crew was just in here. They're repairing the sentry turret, and let's see, the gens look okay. Everything's powered and whatnot. Sentry turret down below is arm operational as well. Don't see a whole lot. Well, there's a deployable by the VPAT, so not a whole lot of vehicle pad pressure being applied by Pendragon. Mason the Fist, grab. He gets mind dissed off the flag stand. Incoming capper, maybe. Going for the flag, trying to find it. Doesn't look like anybody really managed to get too far with it. Anyway, incoming LD. Now it looks like some Ho. There we go. Incoming Ho skis right into the flags in there and gets stuck. Now jumping mortars and mines on that MPV, trying to take it out. Where's he going? I got Chiron behind. MPV takes a little bit of pain, but still alive. Bomber exploding there in the distance as it manages to get a few bombs pretty close to the MPV, but not quite close enough. Somebody trying to chain down that MPV now, looks like. Putting a lot of chain gun fire, getting bounced around over here. Let's pick up some action on the Inferno flags, and we'll watch Bruce Lee for just one second. Bruce Lee going out here doing some hoe work, and just hopping his way along. Looks like he's cresting the hills here, and let's go check out and see what's up on the Inferno flag stand. Inferno flag stand, they're tossing some flesh for that MPB, but it's still looking pretty good, as it just, they've switched out to a plasma turret. I'm not opting to... go for that missile, and Irish 5-7 actually in his Hoff gear now, hanging right here by the flag stand, and missile turret up there in the back, and it looks like, was that a Shrike, and maybe, or somebody duking it out back there, maybe it's one of the Pendragon Shrikers, probably maybe Varkus. Yeah, it's indeed Varkus, the man who we've all come to know and love, thanks to a whole ton of Shrike Observer bugs, but we're gonna grab by Arvid, Arvid or Arvid, but Arvid here with the flag trying to disjump away with it gets popped up into the sky. He's got a little less than a third and an easy snipe shot as he gets high, high up into that sky, and flag sliding back down into the hands of a teammate who's waiting there for the escort. It's Dragon Reborn. Dragonborn's halfway dead. Shrike explodes behind him. He's chunking flares. Disc exploding right behind him sends him a little bit reeling, but Lot's still not healthy. He's going. Freaky's got a grab, trying to save at the last second. Mortar on Dragon Reborn from Codeman, and it's going to get returned by Killbox. Killbox has the return. Freaky's bouncing way up high into the sky here with the flag, and Freaky here still going, bouncing off the ground. Freaky here strikes behind him. Not sure how many are friendly. That was a hostile one going for the rundown. Misses, explodes on the ground beneath him. Freaky here coming back home with just a little bit of health, and his flag is grabbed by Arvid. Arvid here now already back, beats Freaky back to his own flag stand, picks up the flag, but is going off into the middle of nowhere with it. Doesn't have much of a route, just kind of hugging the flat terrain. Strike coming in for the rundown. He opts, looks like for a disc jump there. Pops himself up. He had his repair kit. Didn't take any pain on the flag stand. Freaky is down. Freaky picks up his own flag and coming back past him of his own team's Ho, and looks like a midfielder there. He's bouncing up the hillside, coming back. A Shrike tailing him the whole way. One Shrike blows up behind him. There's still one more back up there. Looks like it's coming for the rundown. Misses. He's still got chasers on him. They're right there next to him. Looks like he might have gotten body blocked there and come to a dead stop as several Storm players catch up with him and they get taken out. But Arvid here just continuing back. Nonetheless, Arvid now getting body blocked by teammate. Chunks it off to his friend Just. Just here with the flag stand. He's getting popped around by some discs and taken out where lots of disc action on him. And flag now in position. Well, see, we've got a return though. That was by Jive. Freaky going to the stand for the cap. 3-0. And flag has been returned and capped. 3-1 up. And hang on one sec, guys. I got to check something. I got a suspicion that somebody in my house is running some programs that are using a bit of bandwidth, so I'm getting them to close down. I apologize for that delay. Anyway, back here on the flag stand, and things are a little quiet now, really. Over by the flag stand, it's off, got knocked off, knocked into one of the ditches, trying to find out where it went. But it's secured on the field, they're going to return it, that's going to be Arnie, going to get that back on. 3-1, again, still in favor of the unhandled exceptions here on the map. Check out the backfield of the unhandled exceptions. Not a whole lot going on back there. V-pads up, inventory station by the V-pad, generators online, sentry turrets up. They got a man in the gens over there. Let's head over to the Inferno side and see what we can pick up. Well, there's Varkas. Everybody knows him. And Mason the Fist here heading out. Probably get set up for him. He's been making a couple grabs. Incoming fully loaded bomber cruising past that flag stand. Takes a bunch of missiles, goes down. Crew eject. Bombs do land on the flag stand. There comes the capper. It's Arvid again. Arvid here comes off from a shrike. He's got a shrike already on him. He's got two chainers, maybe three in the background. They're trying to get some nades on him now as he's bouncing across the midfield ravine. And coming back, Arvid, Shrike net left by him. Looks like a teammate might have stole it almost. But Arvid here coming back with it. No energy, fair bit of health. Coming back for the Pendragons over the hill line. Somebody bailing out. Shrike run down from in front. Looks like it misses and just stops dead on him. But Arvid here bouncing back slowly with it. I'm lagging a lot, guys. And flag will be capped by Arvid. A nice little cowboy cap there. 3-2 is the score. And who we got here? We got Grad. Grad here with the flag stand. He's in the backfield and picked it up off the infernal flag stand and charged straight back into their backfield. Now just jumping to try to get back just to the flag stand. Tiny, tiny sliver of red and takes some pain and goes down, loses that flag. Let's see who we got over here on the other side. We've got Codeman. Codeman here getting ready for go out with an ammo pack. Not sure what that's about, but they got two heavies. One look like two Hoffs over here on the flag stand. I want to say Bruce Lee and Heine Baca as the MPB just now getting back into position over here on the AXC side that's been down for a bit. Looks like they were going for some bombing slash hull pressure. Pendragon is trying to knock that down. Looks like a little bit of blind mortar spam flying across the map. And let's pick up some people on the other side and see how the flag stand over in Inferno is doing. Been watching the Storm one quite a bit so far this map. 15:35 remaining, approaching the halfway mark. It's 3-2, still anyone's ballgame. And who we got? Plasma turn on the MPB. A little bit more removed from the flag stand than I normally see it. But Arvid has a grab. Freaky grabs a second later. Arvid coming in. Shrike's going for the rundowns. No, they all miss. Freaky's down first. Freaky chained down by Just. And Arvid coming. Ryotalog has left the game for the unhandled exceptions. Shrike explodes underneath. Arvid hops right over. His flag's not on the stand. It's returned a second too late. He's destroyed by a missile off the flag stand. Scramble for the flag. Picked up by Just. Just charges. The stand gets the cap. 3-3, and it's been tied up at the halfway mark. And someone's going to cap out with 1 second remaining at the current pace of caps. But Shola here picks up the flag. He's chained down. Loses the flag right into the front ravine in front of the Inferno flag stand. Just sitting down down the gulch. Grenades from up top indicate somebody might be trying to defend it or go for it. But flag down there looks like it's been secured by the light defense. We'll monitor the flag over here a little bit. Bomber there looks like going out from the Pendragon side, getting picked up by a Shrike already. It gets missile down. Bomber continues on its way. Several Shrikes just, well, one of them just being left out there. Somebody eject from a strike. Here comes some mortar spam. They're going for the MPB now. They've got the mortars directly locked onto the MPB, and they're just hammering away on it right now. LD now scrambling out to go get it. You can see at least one of them over there now making his play to try to stop that hoe, and they're taking some pressure over there on the far hillside as the mortars keep coming, at least one more on it, but it not really puncturing the shields. The MPB is not smoking it. A little strike pressure right now will probably finish it off, but it looks like Justice is going to get some repair work on it and get it back up to enough health to survive any more assault. Back here, I still got the missile turret up. Backfield over here on the Inferno side looking pretty good. Two incoming strikes. Strikers coming out, maybe one going for the grab. Indeed, there's the follow-up. First man was a decoy, but grad there looks like ejects a little low and smacks into the flag stand and misses. Grad here now looks like maybe hanging around the periphery looking to make a disrupt for a follow-up capper, but no ops to go in. Retreats, looks like the defense did not see him. He comes back onto the flag stand, gets dissed off it, and is cruising along home. Now, might take a little bit of fall damage here, does so, but still enough health, still moving on his way back, passes up an enemy heavy offense as he cruises, chunks the flag to a teammate, and Grad there, for coming from an almost standstill, almost managed to slip the whole way home with it. Arsenic picks it up, though, and coming back to the flag stand, MPB destroyed in front of him. Did he just kill somebody? Yes, Arsenic on the way back. Shock Lance's Shaggy 1 takes him out, but his flag is off the stand. Arvid has it. Arvid's almost the whole way home. He's in bad shape, though. Coming back to the flag stand, skiing right past it, and he takes a stop. Turns around, looks like he's up in the air. I thought he was going to go for the MPB to get healed up. Destroyed by some grenades. Just picks it up, though, and just it jumps into a shrike, maybe accidentally there, I think, but now he's in a shrike with the storm flag. A shrike is smoking like crazy and is almost destroyed. It's picked up by an enemy shrike, and he bails out, goes for the inventory stations to get inside, finds a deployable one outside, grabs an e-pack, and partially heals himself up, and I'm not bouncing around a little bit. Jive has left the game. Who we got? 13 versus 14, and EXE is just having terrible problems keeping players in this game right now. And Jive leaving the game now, so EXE having to play down a man, just an Arknis. Yeah, just an Arknis. Lunar Warrior, I don't know what's the problem, but anyway, here, Dulce Watch, just an Arsenic, see what's up. Well, Arsenic just inside, and Arsenic is outside. Looks like people are having some problems buffering. I apologize, guys. I don't know what the server settings are right now, at least as packet climb rates, but we're watching Arsenic as he plays around by the flag stand. Let's pick up Just on the other side. Just here hanging around on the lower floor level. Not seeing a whole lot of action, but let's see what's up. Looks like Ryotalog's rejoining the game for the unhandled exceptions out here by the Inferno flag stand. Things going a little slow as this flag stand off, getting into yet another one here. A little under 12 minutes remaining now. Well, who's just playing heavy defense over there? That is Kobe Tai. And so, let's see who's out over here. Heini Baka, looks like the Storm Hop has pulled up and is now defending from the top hill there. The flag secure. Let's see, where are you, Arsenic? Well, Arsenic has retreated indoors as well. Bruce Lee leaves the game. Ryotalog leaves the game. Looks like EXE is just having some terrible problems keeping people to stay on the server, maybe suffering some plagues of their own name. The unhandled exceptions really getting a hold of them. Justin Shola here, just cruising around. That's Shola. He's outside right now. Bruce Lee rejoins the game. Just here inside, just camping in heavy with a shield pack. Both teams tied it up. 3-3. Discs incoming on Shola. He's taking some pain from one chaser, getting bounced, pushed back towards the side of his base, dangerously caught up against the side of the Slapdash base there. Now gets, was that M8? Or I'm not sure, but taken out there. Loses the flag. Teammate immediately comes over to pick it up, though. They were all over the light offense player there and quickly took him out. But it's Shaman here now at the flag, and Ryotalog leads the game once again and just having some mad problems. And who we got over here? Just inside the base. Pull out and let's look around and see what's going on over here. Just not a whole lot going on in the meantime, so things looking a little bit quiet. Let's pick up somebody over on the other side. We got Shaman, we got Just, and things sound like a satchel charge, I thought I heard. I'm looking for that satchel charge, maybe. I'm not sure where that satchel charge is. Looking around for it. Don't see it, but somebody was lighting up a satchel there. Maybe it's on the top floor. They're guarding the top floor. I apologize again if you guys are buffering a little bit. I'm getting some mad skippage here, too, unfortunately. And I think the server's packet/client rate might be set a little bit too high. But anyway, let's check inside the base. Some concussion grenades going off. Somebody gets their pack and equipment blown off. Where is Brad? He's hiding inside the gents here. Takes out somebody there hiding. And who was it? Try to find it. Well, looks like two Inferno players managed to sneak in there. They're going one with a light with an E-pack, one with a light with a sensor jammer pack. Not doing a whole lot in there now. And so let's see what's up over by the V-pad. V-pad getting loaded up with a bomber crew and buying yet another shrike. Head over to the Inferno side and see how they're doing, coping with the flag standoff situation. Nobody outside in the tank, which is something I see a lot on Slapdash, but both teams opting to keep the flag indoors for the most part. There's been a little bit of outdoor work, and they've got Just right out there. Well, lagged, and I go right through him. He's got some cameras, deployable cameras stuck around the walls there with him. He's just sitting there waiting, shield pack on, and flag standoff situation continues now with under 10 minutes remaining on Slapdash. Both teams tying it up, playing it cap for cap, but now flag standoff situation at the start, and again here right now, causing some problems. Just panning around through the players on the team. Shaman there inside the base, just cramped up by the gens. Incoming enemy with a shield pack gets caught up on the inside, going for the inventory station, gets inside. He's tossing concussion grenades bouncing off all over. Did he get return? He got it! Mason the Fist got the return! He bounces him around with concussion grenades, gets the return, and just here now going outside with the flag, and I'm watching this myself in slow motion almost, just now going back inside and going to get passed up. Arsenic has a grab. He comes off the flag stand with full health almost, and Arsenic now here getting back with the flag. Doesn't look like anybody on Pendragon was guarding the flag stand trying to stop Arsenic, so Arsenic now is going to make his way the whole way back, and that flag standoff situation broke, but looks like it's going to continue here once again as Arsenic makes off like a bandit with the Pendragon flag. The generators and the V-pad have gone offline over here on one side. Let's see, Arsenic chunks the flag off to Shola. Shola's got the flag. They're just now repairing the gens inside the base, and several players, this isn't great, well, I wouldn't say great, but this is a decent opportunity now for the Pendragons to really put the pressure, keep those gens, keep those V-pad down, kill that flag carrier and get the return, and they'll have the upper hand here on the map. But 8 minutes to do it, since so before overtime, they've really got to step up the pace here. Incoming Shrikes making some harassment efforts, trying to keep that V-pad down. Looks like it was almost like a satchel charge blowing up on the V-pad there for a second, but Mason the Fist ejecting from a Shrike down and forcing me to get locked on him. I'm trying to get locked off him. And over here now by the flag stand, I'm just getting warped around, and V-pad, tons and tons of players on it, and inside the base, mortars and everything exploding everywhere. Head up now and we'll see what's going on inside. I thought I saw a mortar from somebody blowing up there. I don't know if it was a defensive or offensive mortar, but lots and lots of action, guys. I can't imagine it's not buffering, unfortunately. There's just about 20 people that got killed in the space of a second. Penn Anchorage killed a ton of people with some grenades. You can see the bodies all just piled up all over the storm base, and things are going a little bit slow, even for me on this server. And we've got some fully loaded bombers. I'll watch this for a second, see how it's going. Fully loaded bomber on it, cruising on its way out. And a couple people up there, looks like they're just going with lights in the pilot seat and a medium shield pack in the tail gunner spot. So flying across the field now, looking for any sort of interference. Shrike just now picking them up, and sees they're dumping grenades and bombs, and I get locked up on Barkus as he ejects from a Shrike. There's Arnie, looks like they're trying to take out the players as they come with the flank, and somebody chunking concussion grenades. They're trying to weasel their way into the base and take out, there it is. Flag was dropped there by Shola. Penn Anchorage got him with a mind disc, looks like. And on the other side, Shaman looks like he's going to pass it off to Humpstuff. Humpstuff there in really bad shape. They did a nice job of harassing that base, and I get locked on to Mason the Fist as he gets into a Shrike. Let's pick up Just and see what's up. Just here is looking pretty quiet, looking like he's not seeing a whole lot of actions in here. His inventories are online, his sentries are online, his deployable cameras are still up. Looks like most of the action is being confined to the unhandled exception side. They have been having a terrible problem keeping a couple of their players in the server. Have been playing down up to 2 men at one point. Sounds like there's a heavy outside doing a little bit of mortar fire. But here comes Mason the Fist. He's in the light with the shield pack. He's trying to sneak in, I bet, try to get some concussion grenades. Humpstuff loses the flag. Orion picks it up. I don't know if it got conked off him or what. Orion there is with the E-pack. Still on the lower floor, and more bodies piling up on the outside. And things are just getting absolutely warpy on my end. I'm just getting I'm looking at my little lag meter here real quick. It's up and down and all over the place, guys. I'm getting drops occasionally from the server. I'm not sure why that is. But anyway, here we are with Justin Orion and flag standoff. Just has lost it on the other side. I'm not sure how he lost the flag. Orion loses it. Just picks it back up. A little bit of pressure on Justin. There we go. I warped through the wall. There you go. Just, you can tell by the bodies that are all hooked up here on the outside that things not going too bad. Let's see what's up inside. Just, we're going to get the right name on the screen for you. Just here hanging around, some concussion grenades exploding in the doorway for him. Over on the other side, Mason the Fist ejecting. Looks like he missed a little bit. Crashes down below. Head up over to it, and wow, am I getting some madman skippage down into the base here. A flag is dropped. Got knocked off by concussion grenade. They tossed right back the heavy on flag. Down to under 5 minutes, guys. 5 minutes remaining here on Slapdash X, and things are just getting totally clusterfucked around the bases. Both teams are just piling up the bodies and grenades inside that base. But nothing breaks a good look at a base like Mason the Fist jumping into a Shrike. So let's head over here to the Inferno side as I warp around. Something going on the inside here, and I got a flag dropped, passed off, picked up now. And who is it? I'm trying to pick it up again. It's Minion. Minion chunks the flag off to his teammate. It's Shola now with the flag. Shola here with the flag hanging around at the base, and now getting a little bit more laggage. And some concussion grenades now being spiked inside the base. You guys are hopefully seeing this a lot better than I am, because I'm getting a little bit of a some warpage here. But Shola here now inside the base. Teammates running around all around him. And not a whole terrible lot going on. Got a return! How was that? That was Code, man! Just lost the flag. Did he get killed? I don't see him getting killed. It must have been conked off, and the flag got conked off just. Code Man returns. Arsenic going to the stand. He's got motors, everything exploding. What? Charge. Does he get it? No, he's body blocked by a teammate, but turns around and gets it anyway. The flag standoff is broken. The unhandled exceptions are up now. 4-3 on Slapdash. Under 4 minutes remaining. The flag standoff is over, ladies and gentlemen. And now things are looking good for the UEs. They've been playing up and down a few players. They're back up to even right now on the flag stand here. A few bodies piled up around it. And I get a little bit of skippage now that there's tons of players on the screen. But things looking still rather very much in the favor of the EXE players, as they've now only got to defend for the last 3.5 minutes. Grad's going to make a grab, though, on their side. Looks like the unhandled exception's not giving up totally on the offensive end. Grad here disc-jumping out with it. He's down to a tiny sliver of red. Chain gun fire on Balan. He decides to chunk it before he gets killed. Throws the flag, and players ejecting from a shrine to go pick it up. It's just sitting out there in the field. Arvid has a snag, though. Arvid's in bad shape, but he's coming back with a lot of speed. He's got bombs. He's got shrikes. Everything exploding behind him. Teammates coming out. He is taken out. Dropped by Codeman's grenade. It's going to get picked up by Dragon Reborn. Dragon Reborn is body blocked by a teammate strike. And Arsenic, in the meantime, has a grab. He disc jumps off the flag stand with it. He's heading way off toward the northeastern part of the map with it. Way off here, away from the central routes, away from where Dragon Reborn is. Dragon Reborn, in the meantime, has come back. He's heading back to his base. He's got full health, but on the other side, now Arsenic here cruising back. Let's see if he's picking up any chasers. Takes one chaser disc in the back. He chunks the flag off, spiking it to a teammate, but misses. Flag is skipping along. Grenades exploding everywhere. Whereas teammate Shola goes for it. Shola gets it. Dragon Reborn sneaks off inside. Shola here with the flag. He's in good shape. Got lots of energy. Got lots of health. Bomber parked just aimlessly out near him. Chaser's trying to get some nades on him from behind. Maybe some shrikes. They're trying to do some rundowns. Missiles on those shrikes right now. Shola's in bad shape. He's got the flag most of the way home. Shrike coming in for the rundown. Knocks him. Sends him reeling into the side of a hill. He is immediately chained down. The flag is sliding, scrambling forward. And Varkas comes up with a return. Varkas comes up with a return for the Pendragons. Dragon Reborn here coming back to the flag stand. Under 2 minutes remaining. Incoming capper misses. Dragon Reborn caps the flag. Dragon Reborn will cap and tie this up with 4-4 with 2 minutes to go. Slapdash X might be looking at an overtime here, but people have proved me wrong. It only took them 2 minutes to get a cap per team. So now with 2 minutes remaining, just enough time for maybe one more team to wind up with that one winning cap. It's going to come down to who can get it. Inferno stand is just totally littered with debris. MPB is down. Hoff is off. I see no deployable in... Well, there's one over there. There's one deployable in the Tory Station. I don't see very many land spikes. Well, is that one? Yep, land spike. They've got a few deployables up. I shouldn't say it's quite there. It's just scattered with lots of debris. And over here, David Heavy Offense. Heavy on flag still on. Few LD. Again, no MPB on this side either. Missile turrets up. Sensors are down. And flag stands. Really, both teams here caught a little off guard with a minute to go. Both teams are probably going to get one more offensive chance at this. One more chance to get some cappers in 60 seconds. It's enough time to score that one potentially winning cap. But I'm not seeing it from either team right now. Where are the strikes? You know, let's go head back over here to the Inferno side and see if we can find somebody out by the flag stand. Well, there's Irish 5-7. Looks like getting loaded up. Killbox has a snag. There's Killbox. There's Arvid. Here are the final grabs of the game, probably. Arvid is out with a lot of speed and 2/3 of his health. He's probably snipeable, but he is motoring home. Killbox in the meantime. M8 in the back. Varkas destroys him. No, I'm sorry. That wasn't an M8. That was a rundown. Scramble for the flag, though. It's going to get picked up by Shola. Shola takes a disc. Shola's in bad shape. He is just in terrible. There's vehicles everywhere behind him, and he's running for his life, and he's getting chained down. In the meantime, Arvid's in bad, taking some pain over here. Shola here, bad shape. He is taken out. Arsenic, though, picks it up immediately. On the other side, Arvid goes down, passes it to Mason Navis. 10 seconds, and both teams slip out with the flag with 1 minute to go, and that is going to go into overtime. 4-4, ladies and gentlemen. Match is over in regulation. Killbox with 400 points. Most kills going there to Shaman of the Unhandled Exceptions, and Humpstuff from, I believe that's, he's on UE as well. Well, let's see if I can tell right now. But anyway, Storm and Inferno tying it out. Next stream for OT coming up soon.